Understanding content on the web is an important issue on the current web. Let's start by an example. Here is a sentence from David James during the World Cup 2010. Why is snob me fab? To understand this sentence, we need to disambiguate who fab is. Fab can have different meaning, like a detergent, a Canadian gay magazine, or so many other meanings. But the real meaning here is the manager of UK national football team, Fabio Capello. So as you see, we need to define semantics explicitly within our web documents. We need to define Fabio Capello as an entity, which is a soccer manager, and soccer manager as a subclass of person. Semantic documents aim to add semantics to current web documents so that they are understandable by both humans as well as machines. They provide different advantages for information management. In search and retrieval, they provide faceted browsing, question answering, they provide sophisticated ways of visualizing information, and many more advantages in information integration, personalization, reusability, and interoperability. But the question is how to author semantic documents. WYSIWYG model is currently very popular for most of the web users. We aim to provide a similar approach for authoring semantic documents. We call it WYSIWYM. WYSIWYM concept aims to provide a mapping between semantics and user interface. So we provide a set of bindings between existing UI elements and existing semantic representation models. We created RDFAs as an implementation of the WYSIWYM model. It adds some extra buttons on top of the existing WYSIWYG editors. It supports a set of natural language processing APIs to automatically annotate content. The content can then be revised by user. Here you see the triple browser in which you can browse the facts embedded within your document, and you can edit or delete them as well. In RDFAs, you can select some part of the text and then you can assign properties to it. It has a recommender which suggests related properties to you. Different configurations of WYSIWYM model can be used for different personas. For example, a journalist can use the context menu to easily add the annotations to an article. So he doesn't want to get distracted from the normal process of authoring, so he just sees very lightweight borders around the entities, and at the end he can use the automatic annotation feature to annotate the entities. On the other hand, metadata curator needs to see more details. So he sees different entities in different colors, he sees more details by tooltips, he can change the type of the entities, he can add more details to the entities, he can delete, or he can even add new semantic entities into the document. He can also use drag and drop to make associations between two entities. So here he mentions the name of this association and then he sees the association by these arrows. Another use case is a product manager who is interested in search engine optimization. He can draw some lines around the content and he can use hierarchical forms to add metadata to his product. As you see here, he creates a rectangle around the release date, and then in the appropriate form, he can enter the corresponding date for this product. In this video, we presented the WYSIWYM concept as an acronym for what you see is what you mean. We showed RDFAs as an implementation of the WYSIWYM, and we described some examples of bindings for journalist, metadata curator, and product content manager. Of course, there are more bindings available for annotation of images and videos. We also employed WYSIWYM in other domains. We created a tool called Farmer for authoring semantic medical prescriptions.